combined 7th and 8th grade band. These guys have been rock stars all year. They particularly impressed me with their work ethic. Now, talent is one thing, but to have kids that just want to work every day is an awesome thing to work with. And they really came to show that at contest season, where I know you guys saw and heard what they did. It was really outstanding. One of the best performances I've had in 10 years. Tonight we've got some fun music for you they've been working on. We're starting with All Star. We're going to move on to From Now On, The Greatest Showman. And then we will finish with Putting on a Prayer.
Thank you.
take a quick moment to thank, in particular, our 8th grade parents. A 5-year journey, and some of you longer, depending on if you've had kids with me before, it's quite a journey, something like you don't go on with many teachers, with the ups and downs. I really appreciate everything you guys have done. Everything from pancake breakfasts to parades to bus rides. It's really a unique experience, and I get to know these kids a little bit differently than most teachers, seeing them in 4th grade. Really starting to recruit them as early as 2nd, 3rd, 1st grade when we do our elementary school tours. That's really a recruiting ploy. They do come into Navajo with a little bit of an idea of who we are and what we can do here. We've been on a long journey together. We just want to say thanks. So I'm going to start with my booster moms. These are a couple of people I'm graduating out, and there are some openings if anyone's bored. They've been with me for a long time. They are 8th grade parents. And we just want to show a token of our appreciation. So if I could have them come up, we have Mrs. Kasher. Mrs. Castor. And Mrs. McCarthy. So a sincere thank you to those guys. They're my sounding board whenever I have questions or crazy ideas. They've been a huge asset. Next, we're going to call our 8th grade students up, and we're just going to simply ask them to bring a flower to their parents here tonight. I do ask them to hold applause until the end so we can get through this in a timely fashion. 8th graders, when I call your name, please come on up, get a flower, and find your parents. Elise Alligood, Abigail Beach, Thomas Begley, Kiera Bruton,